Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back. This is XCOM 2 Operation Blood Queen. We're looking to neutralize an Advent VIP on a PR tour. Now, this is a new mission type. Admittedly, I've never played it before. This is part of the additional mission types mod from the guy who made the Haven Siege. And I think there's a couple of other missions in there now. But regardless, it's a quote-unquote easy mission. We're going to take out Gagnon, Albrecht, Oxton, McKinsley, and Yamakaze. Should we bring a med kit? Not until we had this. I had this kind of epiphany last mission where I was like, "Something's bugged. Like, why can't I remotely heal?" Because we don't have the remote heal on like unlocks. It's just not. I was dumb. But I'm gonna just keep grenades. Maybe flashbang wouldn't have been a bad idea. Oh well. We've got six grenades. That's gotta help us somehow, right? Famous last words.
Spokesman has confirmed the location of a VIP valuable to the alien cause moving in this area, and he's asked that we use this opportunity to neutralize the operative. Secure the surrounding area and remove all enemy security forces guarding the target. Bring him in alive if possible, dead if necessary.
Bring him in alive if possible, dead if necessary. It says here that they're going to go on high alert if the VIP's life signs go null. So if we kill him, then maybe things go pretty wild. We haven't had to do that before, so I'm not going to try to do it now. But this is Needle Junction, Cape Town. Blood Queen, Needle Junction. Coincidence? I think not.
Menace 1-5, target location confirmed. Move
okay,
to engage.
The target's in the diner.
All hostile
repeat,
contacts.
Target's in the diner. Sitting down, probably unaware that we're trying to capture him. It's fair. We just have to get over there. Now, we don't have a turn timer. That's all we have to do is capture, kill the Advent VIP. So, what's the twist? Let's bring Albrecht. He's the newbie of this
of this group. Moving on target.
He and McKinsley, I guess. So let's have them start the scouting. Not gonna get very far, but that's okay. We do have the road here, which I would really like to utilize if possible. Let's bring Oxton up to the front. That's gonna be a problem, apparently. What is that? That's a pretty bruised little dude there. A sectoid negator. So he's got Solace. It's a Psy operative surrounded by an aura that immediately extinguishes or blocks any mental impairments or for themselves and nearby squadmates. Okay. Interesting. So negates the effects that you place, I guess. I wonder what happens if you target them. Like, I was just talking about the flashbang. If I was to bring a flashbang in this scenario and we flashbang that sectoid, does it just not affect him? Or if we flashbanged his friend and he goes by, he removes that. Fair enough.
I'm on the move.
Copy, Whiskey.
I just want to get as close as possible here because we're going to go up top. Let's hold off a turn. We're in no rush. There's no timer ticking. That's cool. He's like black and purple and black. That's cool. The first version of this mod when it came out, the Better Advent mod, was doing some pretty wacky things with the colors of the troopers. Like, they would be like bright green and bright yellow and like just, you know, like bright, like neon. And you're like, eh, questionable.
Solid copy, 3-9er.
Heading to that location.
Man, I love her voice.
Good copy. Moving on target.
I don't know why. But it's just really cool. Let's just stick here for now. See, now this is always the scary thing, right? Is that we can easily get revealed if we're not careful. It looks like this one was safe. I'm just gonna go here.
Affirmative.
Just to be even safer. I just wanna keep eyes on these guys as they're moving around. And then we're gonna start patrolling down closer to that VIP, I think.
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
Orders confirmed.
And then we'll just adjust as we go.
Roger that.
So I don't really know what we're supposed to be doing after we get this VIP.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. They could totally be coming up here. I'm gonna drop down.
Solid copy, whiskey 2-8.
Please don't find me. Where are they? Okay, so it doesn't look like they're coming up top, which is helpful. And since they're like pretty much underneath, I don't think they can see up here.
Position confirmed.
Let's bring Oxton in. We'll bring in Yamazaki.
Okay.
Or Yamakaze, depending on who you ask.
Affirmative.
And then let's bring Codex up here as well. We're getting close to the VIP. We'll just stay here with McKinsey.
I'm on it.
On overwatch.
They're still moving. I don't want to lose them. I don't want to lose track of them. So I don't know, like... Uh-oh. That's why. So I don't know how many pods are out there. There's at least two. Option number two is that we can go scouting up top with McKinsey, but I think we'd be better served staying down below. Would this be safe?
Understood, 1-8.
Let's tuck in here. Found that group again. Let's just stay there for now. We can still afford to move down. I actually wouldn't mind staying within, like, the range of this, alleyway.
Understood.
So that we have shots all the way down it, if necessary.
Roger that.
Of course, I would love if we were against full cover here, but can't get everything that you want.
Confirmed.
I don't suppose... Nah, the angles. Because math. We can't see them because of math.
Eyes
on the prize.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
I'm in position.
Got it
covered. Roger, I've got my eyes on.
Okay, they're starting to walk back. This is good. Uh-oh. This is good. If these guys meet up, we could throw down here and have a pretty successful engagement. This is all theory, of course.
Menace 1-5. Shit,
she's...
Is unable
oh!
To approach the AO for evac. You're on your own out there.
Whoa!
Regroup and try to buy us some time for an extraction. Take out those hostiles.
Okay. Firebrand's return. So 8 turns till they're back, which means we can't even extract that soldier, or that VIP, for 8 turns. So we have to... It says, hold out till Firebrand's back in the AO. I like what it says till instead of until, but whatever. I mean, do we want to engage here? I think fighting 5 is pretty aggressive, but we do have those 3 in a really good grenade spot. Like, really good grenade spot. So we'd overwatch here, or so we'd throw the grenade, okay? Probably get kills with the rest of these guys. And depending on if we get the 4 damage on this front guy, we're gonna need at least another shot or two on those others, but then we have these guys to deal with too. So I'm not sure we wanna do this, but I'm worried now that these guys are gonna patrol back here and catch her out, but maybe those guys will patrol back as well.
I'm in cover.
Let's wait it out and see what happens. This could be a problem. The other option, now that we're in this scenario, is we just wait, and maybe they shoot back, maybe they don't, but that's the risk we are taking here by not engaging. Pretty sure we're getting revealed here. There it is.
We got incoming.
Let's see how this goes. Oh, Jesus, Louises. Hey, that's good.
Well, how about that?
And they're gonna get shots on these guys, so this could be worse. Oh, that Viper. Wow, he absorbed all that damage.
I got it, right?
Okay, this is actually not bad. That worked out because we didn't get killed immediately. But that's the only reason. That is the only reason. Okay, so Yamazaki's got two shots if we want it. 275s over here. We could also use the grenade, but I like the damage output too. So, let's think about this. If we use two grenades, that leaves three people to shoot, right? Who do we need to do the shooting? Well, technically, Lena does a lot of damage, but her aim is not the greatest. If we remove that guy's cover, though, he'll be at 100%. She does 5 to 7 damage. That's important. Albrecht, he does the least damage, and so probably we'll be looking to dish out his grenade. McKinsey's got a shotgun. She's got high damage output. Yamazaki can shoot twice. We just want to make sure that those hit. It's his aim 75, but he's got cover. Just dropping it to, 75. So he would be at 95. Or he'd be at 100 over here. So again, a really good option. Then we have Gagnon, who's got pretty good damage output. 4 to 6 over there. If the cover's removed, she can hit either of them at 100%. And then we just have this little guy. I don't know if... It depends if we crit or not. And we'll decide this stuff, but... yeah. I think with McKinsey,
sir,
we'll bring her around here for a flank. Let's see what she can do. 50% to crit. Come on. Yes. 8. Well, still got to hit it. Now, we don't have to... Like, we can still flank with Oxton here. If we bring Oxton down, get this shot, and then we bring, I don't know, not Yamazaki, but we would bring probably Codex at that point to try and finish him off. Then we've got two shots at 75%, and only one needs to hit on the sectoid. And then last but not least, we would have enough damage to... Well, we'd have one shot at killing this guy, and we could move down there and flank him. So, it's interesting. We could also move down here to take the shots on that guy. It looks like. The thing is that Oxton's shot on him will kill him for sure if she hits, right? So if we bring Codex down, that's 3 to 5 damage. Then we've got Gagnon. We're not gonna move her anyways, right? More than likely we're not. We could use the grenade. But that cover, like, the cover removal is unreliable. Let's take this. Oh, actually, what's your pistol shot? Not as good. Come on, 83. There it is. Okay, that's helpful.
That's it.
So now, I'm gonna bring Albrecht way back here. Oh, the crit too. Beautiful job. Beautiful job. And now we could take the two, or we just move in for a safer shot. I think that's what we do here. There it is. Dodge all you want. And then he's got low cover. We can negate that. Can't flank him from over here for some reason. It's interesting. We can't see him from over here, but we can see him from over here if we move. That's weird. That's really weird. I wonder why that is. Okay, so we're getting the height advantage at 20, right? If we move down, he'll be flanked, so he's not going to have any cover bonus, but then we lose the 20%. So it's gonna equal out to nothing, like neutral. And we don't need crit here, so I think we just take the shot. It's pretty good. There you go.
Not too shabby.
All right. Now what though? Let's get reloads in.
Oh yeah.
I think we should probably bring her back to the group. Got pretty separated there.
Locked and loaded.
Oh yeah.
So five turns until Firebrand comes back. We have to hold out. Now, what's happening with the VIP at this time? Like, I have no idea. Should we be going for it, or should we just actually just be sitting here holding out?
Get it covered.
Oh, what the shit was that? That's not good. Oh, that's not good. Ooh, that was a misclick that could have been a death.
I can handle that.
I'm on it!
Keep it steady.
Chunk yourself. Scanning!
Did you hear that?
Oh god, no.
Advent forces on the ground.
No! Oh, they're up top, actually. That's pretty good. If they were underneath, that could have been bad. Is anybody gonna hit these guys, or...? Yep, that'll work. Okay, we hit one. And they're bringing in reinforcements. Fuck, that did actually hurt us being up there like that. Because that would not have exposed these guys, and he's our guy that shoots twice. Alright. So. I think we gotta take the... I think we gotta take this damage. Right? Go for the fall damage. Where's the VIP? It doesn't show us. It's in there, I'm pretty sure. Is it in that building? I think so. This will kill the soldier, the officer, and maybe the other guy. The assault. I'm not sure how the assault functioned totally. They've got the stun lancers, but their aim's not that good. I'm not sure how they work. But if we can get him to take some fall damage, that would be okay.
Heads down!
Well, the VIP's right underneath that. Oh no. I think I killed the VIP. We hurt the VIP. Didn't kill him. Thank God. That could have been a pretty crucial error. Okay, what do we want here? We want to have somebody back to overwatch this drop.
I can handle that.
Let's bring Albrecht back. We have Yamazaki down here. We don't have any good cover positions, really. Uh, This... Oh, no, that's only half cover. Here we go. This could work. It's better than nothing. Will he still see him? Yes. We could also look at going inside into half cover there. I don't really like that. Let's pull back into full.
On the move.
You know what? We might even just use a grenade here. What I'm trying to do is see if I can squeeze in an extra shot on this guy at 71% that nobody else is going to be able to shoot. And then I can bring McKinsey back here for an Overwatch up close.
Acknowledged.
You know what? I'm not going to be cheap with our grenades here. We're just going to get rid of anything that we see. And that's a real stun lancer back there. Nice. Okay.
Set up a defensive perimeter.
What do we have for hacking? Override and distraction, both pretty low chances. And then jammed. What does jammed do against us? All enemies get defense and mobility boost. For a 50% chance that they gain complete immunity for the next two attacks, which is nice, but I don't think we can fully use that to our advantage, so I'm not gonna use it.
Got it going.
Okay, I'm not too worried about these guys. Not yet. Depends where they scatter to.
Advent forces sighted.
They got me flanked.
Damn it. Oh, he missed him. That sucks. Whoa.
They're all over me.
That was freaky. Okay, hold on. So where'd the other guy go? So he jumped out in front. Let's reload here.
Reloading.
Chances to hit him are pretty nice. You know what, though? What we could do is just get in there with the sword. I could then bring, I could bring Albrecht down in full cover, flank him, hopefully kill him. Or we could even not use full cover. We could just come up here. Nobody's going to be able to see him. And he's going to have a great shot.
It's going to be the greatest shot in the world.
We're going to make him pay for the shot. There it is. Paid for it, all right. Then, we could use the slash here. No!
Unacceptable.
No shit, unacceptable. That was like a 96% chance. Oh my god. Like, we can't be having that stuff happening. Like, it just can't be happening. You know? Now I gotta bring Oxen back here. Might not even kill her. It. That. He's stuck there, though, so he's gonna have to go down and take a shot up, but it's still only half cover, so I'm not a huge fan. Understandable. We still have Yamazaki, who can shoot twice. But 266 is not bad. I would say we're better off moving in here for the flank.
On your order.
Let's do this. Okay, good stuff.
Seems doable.
This is not a great chance. There you go. That's how it's done. Good job, Oxton. And then we still have a decent shot over here. 50-50 if it hits. And if it hits, he's probably dead unless he dodges it, which is possible because he's a stun lancer, he's a piece of shit. Oh! I'm pumped like I did that, you know, but like I did nothing. I just hit the button. Oh,
whatever,
man.
You say.
That was
solid
awesome.
Copy, 3-9-er.
Apparently, 90% are like my enemy right now. I'm so nervous. I used to feel like 70, yeah, let's do it. We got that. No problemo. Less. I do not feel like that anymore.
On overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
Scanning.
Commander, we've got what we came for. It's likely the enemy will keep sending reinforcements. We should get our people out of there.
Oh, okay. Okay, okay, okay. So, who should we send in there? Probably Albrecht, right? Is he... Oh, what is he sitting on? Is he on something? Oh, man. I'm really hoping we can do the knockout.
Commander. I'm on it.
Covering now. Okay, they're bringing guys in up top. That's fine by me. Let's subdue the target.
Status confirmed. Target package in custody.
Now what?
I got you.
Do we call in? Extract Advent VIP? Yeah, okay. So we can call the Sky Ranger. Say we just chuck her down right here, no?
Requesting immediate evac! Seems doable.
That's a cool mission type, actually. I dig that.
On the move.
I really like that.
Double time.
Will do.
And we got out. We almost killed the VIP because of incorrect grenade placement. But it worked
VIP
out.
VIP secure and in position for evac. This is fine.
Only slightly injured.
VIP is secure.
Status
that
confirmed.
Is a cool mission type. I like that. There's a little bit of like defense, there's a little bit of I think there's a little bit of everything there. That's cool. It's a nice change. Very nice change. Heavy hitter, Albrecht. Yep. McKinsley, most assists. Solo Slayer, Oxton, not surprised. Most high, Albrecht. Yamazaki, kill stealer. Cool. I'm liking, like, our squad's starting to feel, like, relatable, you know? There's all these soldiers have, like, a thing, kind of, that's making them interesting. To me, anyways, I don't know. I still kind of feel bad that Oxton is from, Overwatch. And, yeah. Next season, whenever that happens, what I'll probably do is I'll send out like a giant list of the recruits on Twitter or something and saying like, are any of these video games that I don't know about? Okay. Let's see. Now, the last time I picked blast padding, a lot of people didn't agree with that. And like, I see why. I definitely see why. Now that we have somebody with blast padding, I'd probably take Shredder, and we are running into a lot of enemies with armor, albeit only one right now. Actually, no. We've seen some enemies with two armor, but only three health. But let's grab Shredder, because we do want to have a diversified Grenadier platform. McKinsley, how do we want to play you? I'm kind of seeing you as more of a... Actually, yeah, considering that last sword attack that you made, we're gonna just stick with our traditional scouting ranger with Phantom. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Infantry, 10% to hit and 20% against flanked or uncovered enemies. We do get to flank regularly. But I just feel like the opportunist is so good too. That extra 20% to crit though is really nice. And once he starts getting better weapons, I think we could even give him a shotgun if we wanted to. Let's give him Harrier. I think our last infantry we went opportunist, and then I can't remember what this is, but went over to the irregular side. Good job, team. Peter Smits. Well, we gotcha. We gotcha. Viper autopsy.
Another impressive effort.
Intel
Commander.
Countered the
My
minor breakthrough.
Were
Wills
high,
restored. That
and
was like.
Yet you have exceeded them.
That was fantastic for us. All right. So mag weapons down to 9 days.
Our work is proceeding.
We're
going to
take a quick pause on that and open up a lockbox here.
I'll ensure that this new project takes highest priority, Commander.
Thank
Once
you, Tygan. Appreciate
report,
that.
I'll notify you immediately.
All right, so there's rookies there. We don't really need that. What we need is this engineer.
Avenger plotting new course.
And then we need to start expanding, like rapidly. I feel like we're a bit behind there.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing
okay.
as I do, Commander.
Rare grenade launcher. So far, everything that we've gotten has been a rare. And I don't know if it's like, if that makes it rare or not. Maybe that's just like, I don't know, the standard level. Maybe it's rare because it's like, it's in a lockbox. But, let's assign new research. And let's go back to the mag weapons.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
So this is, not the cannon. This is the grenade launcher. And this, let's see, when firing... The soldier, cool. I guess that's cool, I don't know. When firing, the soldier has a 5% chance that the shot will not cost an action for the active turn. So, I mean, that's cool, I guess. Like 5% for every grenade launcher isn't that much, but I guess how often are they really shooting or doing anything in a mission? There's probably maybe 8 or 9 times, so every couple missions, maybe we get that free one. I'm not complaining because, I mean, we're going to use it, right? Now let's see, with Suchik here, if we change his... Yeah, we're gonna change this. Because there is no weapon color on it. Let's do like, what's striking my fancy right now? Not much. Let's do this dark green. That didn't work. Do we have to just change this thing? To change the color, maybe? Yeah, exactly. I don't know if this will maintain its color if we pass the rare grenade launcher around. I'm not too sure, to be honest. Let's see, let's go... Let's do Hex Web. Hex Web's cool. And let's just rename this for him. What's his nickname? AKCS. And then I'm hoping that the color would stick with the rare grenade launcher, but maybe it won't. It'll probably just be whatever that guy's carrying, which will most likely be the rare cannon as well. So it'll probably just adapt to that color, but we'll see. Okay, let's get back to it here. So 5 days left. Vigilance, which means their detection radius is much higher. I mean, there's way worse. So I think all things considered, that's fine. Nice. So we have a new ranger in Dio Looney Carada. I like that. That's cool. The mask, I don't know what it is. It just feels like, yeah, you'd be a ranger, you know. Guerrilla tactics. Nothing. I guess. You know, we could grab Vulture. 153 supplies. We have a bunch of corpses we can sell. So, that's fine. Haven't had any Advanced Warfare Center promotions yet, and it's been up for quite a while. There's a lot of people that, unless they were getting that special perk at Squatty, we should get a bunch of those perks. I don't have the retroactive one on because I still believe that those special perks should be, they should feel special, right? Not every soldier should get that, so.
Power relay now operational.
Okay, very nice. Very nice. Power relay there. I can't put two in there, so we may as well start clearing. How's our healing going? 16 days, 36 days on Durand. It's a long time. We could put somebody in there to drop this down to 4, 8, and, but we have plenty of other soldiers, so I'm gonna actually not do that.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
We're gonna go ahead and start clearing out this machinery with Felix.
I think Dad would have been proud of what we're doing here.
And then we can throw the second one in there as well. Nice. Dr. Min Kim. Cool. Very cool. So the next thing we're going to be building is probably, well, maybe communications. I'm not sure. So that brings that down to 30 days. We're certainly light on engineers. Getting a bunch of engineers early on is such a nice little bonus. Who are we gonna train next? Let's do... Let's do... Gregory Grigorju. GG. GG. GGJ. And what do we want? I'm thinking Grenadier, honestly. Early on, it's just such a huge help. And we gotta make sure we have at least one on every mission. So I think right now, we're alternating between, what, two? Yeah, we have two Grenadiers right here. So, yeah, we still have a ton of rookies, actually. And a pretty thin squad when you think about it. With fatigue playing a factor. A lot of people are anti-fatigue mod, and I get that. But it's forcing me to use a lot of different soldiers, so I'm enjoying that. It's making things a bit more challenging, I'll admit. But that's okay. Okay, so now we're definitely gonna make contact. We'll make contact here, I think. We do have a supply drop in 9 days. And if we wanted to, we could squeeze out a bit of extra money by building a relay here for 50 supplies, and then we would get an additional 118. And we can get that done before the supply drop as well. So that would net me an extra 60 supplies, which isn't bad. But I can always get those extra supplies next month, where I think what we should focus on is expanding. We're still going to get 44 extra supplies here just for doing that. So I think that's the play. That's what we'll do. And it's cut in half because of that supply drop thing that we picked up, or the scan that we did in that area.
Available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Attempting to establish.
Come on, mag weapons. Come on. Damn it. Retaliation. All right. Let's do it. Operation Bloody Rhyme.
Course for sector 13, South Africa.
Telling you right now, mag weapons would be super nice to have at this point in time. Okay, everybody. Clear out your weapons. Make weapons available. What do we have? Hawk, you've made it. You're back. Let's give you the... We can give you your own rifle. That's cool. We have a couple of grenadiers. Actually, no, we only have one. We're gonna bring Suchik. Let's go ahead and give him the rare cannon and the rare grenade launcher. The rare grenade launcher, I'll admit, doesn't feel that rare. And it does take on the color of what the rare cannon was, so that's cool. What's next? Let's take out... Ooh, man. Guess we'll take out Hirpe, who now does fully have medical protocol, which makes this med kit actually work the way that I was expecting it to a couple of missions ago, when I, exemently claimed it's bugged. And then realized later in the episode, that's not bugged, you're an idiot. I think a ranger's probably good here. You know what we're gonna do? We're just gonna give it a pattern. Maybe keep the stock color. I don't know what this one is, but we're gonna go with that. We can maybe make it a bit darker. Go brown. Yeah, that's cool. I dig that. Looks a little fancy, potentially, for him, but that's fine. And we'll call it Looney. I should see if there's more weapon skins like this. And see if some of the previous, like, shotgun mods have been fixed so that when you upgrade them, you don't lose all the attachments or whatever. Because there was a big problem with that. So, we have two rangers. Do we have a sniper that we can bring? I don't think so, hey? I guess we're going to be bringing a rogue. No, let's bring a trooper. 68 aim over here, 73 on Hirpe, or Hirpa. So let's go ahead and give her the rare assault rifle. And then let's go ahead and give him... I don't think we have anything with attachments, so Qualina gets to keep his own gun. Doing it. Burnt orange. It's happening. Let's just call it what it is. And then let's go with like a traditional one. Let's go wild. Very, very nice. Okay, I'm a bit nervous here because this isn't like the strongest squad I've ever seen. We have five grenades. We have a grenadier. We have a ranger for... We have two rangers for like raw damage output with the shotgun. They can also get in there with the blades that are fairly unreliable to this point, even though we've boosted them to near perfection. And then we have our squatty Qualina. Oh my god. Wish me luck, I'm gonna need it, guys. See you next time. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.